seizure. They walk in the street uncovered. Their hair shown, their body shown, and they claim Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that they have brain up there. We really doubt the intelligence and we doubt the sensibility of a woman who insists on going uncovered, showing her hair, and showing her arm, and showing her leg, and she says she is a Muslim, and knowing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there's two types of people, I have not seen them, they are the people of hellfire. One of them are women who will be naked but dressed. Meaning they have some clothing on, but they still show a lot of their bodies that should be covered. And they are tilted and they will lead others to their ways. And their hair is up high like that. Those people will never enter paradise. And they're not even going to smell the odor of paradise. So let us take example of our righteous predecessor of this woman who is the woman of paradise. Radiallahu anha. So those people are the people who established Tawheed. In this hadith, the 70,000 people who will enter paradise without any reckoning are establishing Tawheed. And that will bring us to the virtue of Tawheed. We said in the first chapter that we have to establish Tawheed. That was the first chapter. What was the second chapter? The virtue of Tawheed. وَمَا يُكَفِّرُ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. And the third chapter, مَنْ حَقَّقَ التَّوْحِيدِ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. So now we know the importance of Tawheed. We have to establish Tawheed. Whoever establishes Tawheed will enter paradise. But whoever establishes Tawheed completely and perfectly will enter paradise perfectly, meaning without any reckoning and without any punishment. And there are 70,000 people. 70,000 people, if you compare that number with the millions and billions of Muslims, very little number. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from them, especially when we know the hadith of Imam Ahmad, which is a hadith sahih on Thawban. قال ليدخلن الجنة من أمتي 70,000 لا حساب عليهم ولا عذاب مع كل ألف 70,000. 70,000 people from my nation will enter paradise without any reckoning and without any punishment, and with every thousand there is 70,000. So multiply that up, what will it come up to? No.
40 million.
49 million?
Oh, 40. 49.
Every thousand, 70,000.
Hey, that means 70. Every thousand, 70,000.
49 million.
You multiply. 49 million. You have to multiply. So the calculation of it, there is. In 70,000 there is 70. Multiply 70 by 70,000, 4,900,000 people. So the amount of people will enter paradise without any questioning, 4,970,000. Because we have to add the original 70,000. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those people. Having said that, we finish this chapter and we have the issue. The first issue, معرفة مراتب الناس في التوحيد, is to know the level of people in establishing Tawheed. People vary in their establishment of Tawheed. ما معنى تحقيق التوحيد? What does it mean to establish توحيد? we have went through that, to leave all tax association, all tax of sins, and all tax of innovation. المسألة الثالثة ثناؤه سبحانه على إبراهيم بكونه لم يكن من المشركين. Allah praised Ibrahim because he's not from the association. ثناؤه على سادات الأولياء بسلامتهم من الشرك. Allah praised all those أولياء because they were safe from ascribing partners to Allah Azza wa Jal. والذين هم بربهم لا يشركون. The fifth issue is كون ترك الرقية والكي من تحقيق التوحيد. It means to keeping away from catharization, ruqya is the fullest amount of establishing tawheed. But here to leave ruqya, it means to leave seeking ruqya, not doing ruqya, because we know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam established the utmost level of tawheed, and he used to do ruqya to himself and to his grandson, the granddaughter. السادسة كون الجامع لتلك الخصال هو التوكل. Possessing all those characteristics is has to do with depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore at the end of the hadith it says والذين على ربهم يتوكلون, and those who depend on Allah Azza wa Jal. So the person who depends on Allah Azza wa Jal will not fall into superstition, will not practice, ask people to make ruqya for him, and he will not go to the catharization, because he is hoping for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him what he asking for. The seventh issue, the deep knowledge of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who knew that such degree of trust in Allah could not be attained without action. And the reason for that, the companions were questioning, who are those people who will enter paradise without any action? They were questioning. That means those people, they have to do some things to enter paradise, to in this type of perfection. The eighth issue, the superiority of the followers of Muhammad, and they were very much persevering for the righteousness, for the truth. We know this, that the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are the most of the nation, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, and I saw a greater amount of people, and it was said to me, this is your nation. The fifth issue, the virtue of the people of Musa, the follower of Musa, because they were a great type of people who came under the flag of Musa. The 11th issue, that all the nation will be paraded before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The 12th issue, every ummah will be accompanied by its respective prophet. أن كل أمة تحشر وحدها مع نبيها. The 13th issue, generally few people responded to the call of the prophet. قلة من من استجاب للأنبياء. We understand this. يأتي النبي ومعه الرجل والرجلان. The messenger will come and only one.